Good morning to everyone. Now today we begin with a new chapter, which is Deep Water of 12th Standard. Alright, so start. The story Deep Water tells us how the writer overcame his fear of water and learned swimming with sheer determination and willpower. He had developed a terror of water since childhood when he was 3 or 4 years old. The writer had gone to California with his father. One day on the beach, the waves knocked the children down and swept over him. The child was terrified, but the father, who knew there was no harm, laughed. The experience bred a permanent fear of water in the child's subconscious mind. Still another incident, more serious, increased his terror. The writer was trying to learn swimming in the YMCA swimming pool in Yakima. One day, while he was waiting for other boys, a big boy suddenly played a dangerous prank and pushed him into the water. The writer was terribly frightened and he went down 9 feet into the water. When he reached the bottom, he jumped upward with all his strength. He came up, but very slowly. He tried to catch hold of something like a rope, but grasped only at water. He tried to shout, but no sound came out. He went down again, his lungs ached. He had throbbed and he grew dizzy. He felt paralyzed with fear. All his limbs were paralyzed. Only the movement of his heart told him that he was alive. Again, he tried to jump up, but this time his limbs would not move at all. He looked for ropes, ladders, and water wings, but all in vain. Then he went down again. The third time, this time all efforts and fear ceased. He was moving towards peaceful death. The writer was in peace. When he came to consciousness, he would find himself lying on the side of the pool with the other boys nearly. The terror that he had experienced in the pool never left him. It haunted him for years and years to come. It spoiled many of his expeditions of canoeing, swimming, and fishing. It spoiled his pleasures in many lakes in New Hampshire, Columbia, and Pumping Lake, etc. But the writer was determined to conquer his terror. He took help of a swimming instructor to learn swimming. The instructor taught him various actions necessary in swimming part by part. He put his face under water and exhaled and inhaled, raising it above water. He practiced it for several weeks and he had to kick with his legs a few weeks on the side of the pool. At last, he combined all these actions and made the writer swim. He learned swimming, but the terror continued. So deep goes our childhood experiences. So fearful is the fear of fear. Whenever he was in water, the terror returned. Henceforward, the writer tried to terrorize terror itself. He tried to face the new challenge. When terror came, he confronted it by asking it sarcastically as to what it can really do to him. He plunged into the water as if to defy the fear. Once he took courage, the terror vanquished. He faced the challenge deliberately in various places, like the warm lake. He conquered it at last. Thank you.